Well, hi everybody, and welcome to part one in a three-part series on Oracle Business Intelligence, or OBI. This course is designed to orient new users who are going to be accessing, viewing, and modifying reports that others have created. Additional training and authorization is needed to create reports and dashboards from scratch. In part one, we're going to be logging in, identifying a report, and exploring the data in that report. We are presuming that you already have obtained permission to access OBI. Firefox is the recommended browser for OBI, so let's start at the HSU homepage. Find the address bar at the top window. Delete what's there and type in obi.humboldt.edu, and then press the Enter key. You're going to log in with your username and password. A screen opens showing various dashboards. Much like the dashboard in a car, a dashboard in OBI is the page that brings together a number of pertinent information pieces from a variety of sources. The dashboards you will access are usually going to contain reports. As an example, let's view the dashboard for the general fund. Let's go to the top of the screen on the right-hand side and click the button labeled Dashboards. In the drop-down menu, select 2.0.1, the general fund. A report table will appear displaying financial data for the CSU operating fund. Now notice there are five tabs above the table. The tabs have labels such as General Fund Expenditures, General Fund Journal. All the tabs and information they contain make up the General Fund Dashboard. With report tables, the same information can be viewed in a variety of ways. To change the view, use the drop-down located above the table, and it says, please select a view. Choose the view you are interested in, and the report table will change automatically. We find the department view very helpful. To understand what the data includes, you can look at the filter. Much like a coffee filter, a data filter limits what gets included, so you get only those things that you want. A description of a filter that has been applied to the data in the report table is located in the center of the page, just below the table. Now, the filter tells us such things as the department, the fiscal year that the data represent, and we're going to discuss how to modify that filter in the next part of this series. If you're interested in the source of the data in the report, you can drill down. Well, just as drilling into the ground is going to reveal what's underneath, drilling into a report table gives us the information used to generate the numbers and create that table. To drill into the data, click on any of the numbers of the tables that are in blue. Blue numbers are links, so that when you move the mouse over them, an underline will appear. Clicking on one of these numbers activates a menu giving one or more Drill To options. Selecting a Drill To option will open a table displaying the data used to calculate the number you just selected. It's important to pay special attention to the filters in any table you view. Slight differences in those filters can result on different totals because you have different data. When you're finished examining the data, find the return link that's located in the lower left-hand corner of the screen, and selecting the return link will take you back to the main table. At the very bottom of the main screen are links to refresh, print, and export. If you're interested in printing a report, we've found it works best to export to PDF and then print the PDF. To do this, select the Export link and choose the PDF option. The report will open in the PDF viewer. If you're interested in viewing the data in Excel, we found it works best to export the data in tab delimited format and open the exported file with Excel. To do this, choose the Export link, choose Data, then select tab delimited format. A text file will download to your computer. Okay, now that we have a better understanding of report features, join us in part two, and we're going to talk about how to modify your report.